which is most of the people in the U.S. Senate, Republicans and Democrats. I think they think their first name is Senator. My first name is George. So I need your help. It's a big race. It will be the most important primary election in the country, the most contested primary. Whomever beats Bill, whoever wins the Republican nomination, I hope that's me, will face Bill Nelson. It will be one of the biggest races in America. We've got to beat Bill Nelson. He is a liberal. He comes to Florida and sounds like a moderate and uses his folksy charm. He's a liberal. He voted for all these things. He voted for the stimulus. He voted for Dodd-Frank. He voted for Obamacare. He voted to try the 9/11 terrorists in New York City. He was a sponsor of card check, which would take away the right of the secret ballot, which is the union's big measure to take over our businesses. Watch what people do, not what they say. And Bill Nelson needs to go. He needs to go because he's not doing what Floridians need from their U.S. senator. He needs to go because he's canceling out Marco Rubio's vote. Every time Marco votes one way, Bill votes the other and washes it clean. And he needs to go because he's part of the reason that Harry Reid is our majority leader. And Harry Reid needs to go. So when we defeat Bill Nelson and send me there to vote with Marco, we'll vote for the next Republican majority leader in the U.S. Senate. And with a Republican House, a Republican Senate, and hopefully a new Republican president, but even if there isn't a new Republican president, we can save America. We did it in the 90s. Bill Clinton's second term. I never thought I'd be thinking wistfully back about Bill Clinton's second term. But we had a Republican Senate and a Republican House, and you know what we did? We balanced the budget. We reformed welfare. The economy exploded. We need to have a Republican Senate. Frankly, it's more important than the White House. I know that's hard to believe. I know we get all excited, and I do too, about presidential elections. Having the Senate is more important. Got to beat Bill Nelson. And I think I'm the best person to do it. Now look, there's some other folks in this race that are running. One less because one of my competitors is no longer pursuing that. That's Mike Herodopoulos. But there's some other folks in the race. And I say competitors for a reason. I'm not attacking my competitors. I'm not calling them opponents. Now, you know, some of them are attacking me. But any one of us would be better than Bill Nelson. But there are some differences between me and the other folks that are running, and I think you need to know about them. Because you're going to hear a lot of talk. But talk is cheap. And like I said about Nelson, watch what we did, not what we say. Everyone's going to say they're conservative, and they're for less taxes, and against tax increases, and that they're for less spending. But there's only one person in this race who has a record that supports that rhetoric. And that's me. Let me tell you why. I'm the only person in this race who's held office. And there's only three of us in this race who've been in office. Bill Nelson, me, and Adam. I'm the only one of us who's never voted for a tax increase. Only one. I'm the only one of us who has never asked for an earmark. What's an earmark? An earmark is when your legislator brings home the bacon for their hometown or their home state. Now, these projects in and of themselves are not bad, necessarily. A water treatment plant or a road or a bridge or whatever it is. But they are the engine that drive the train of too much spending. And I saw it firsthand. When you get your project in that appropriations bill, you got to vote for it. Even if it's 20% more than last year. Because your project's in it. And if you don't vote for it, you'll never get another project. And that's how they buy people off, in Tallahassee and in Washington. I never requested an earmark. I was one of the first people to advocate a earmark ban. And if you send me back, I never will. I'm the only guy in this race who's held office who can say that. My two other colleagues, competitors, Bill and Adam, who've been in office, they both voted for big tax increases, billions of dollars worth, and they both have been big earmarkers. Not me. Record matters. I'm the only person in this race who's among the front runners in this race, at least, who really has any business experience. Like I said, I helped run one of these major companies in Florida, 171st according to Florida Trend, privately held companies. You need more people with business experience in Washington, people who know how to make a payroll, people who sign not just the back of the check, but the front of the check. Because if you don't know what the real world is like, when you get to Washington, you don't know that it's bizarre and broken. Because you don't have any experience in the real world. I think that matters. And finally, my friends, I'm the only person in this race who's going to beat Bill Nelson. Trust me, he doesn't want to run against me. Because he knows I know what he's done up there. He also knows that I'm going to be able to stand on the stage with him and hold him accountable. And I want you to think about this. Winning the primary is not the goal here. The goal is beating Bill Nelson and saving America. So we've got to be able to win and cross the finish line and win in November, or it doesn't matter about the primary. And there's going to be a stage a year and so from now, in the fall of 2012, and there's going to be two podiums on it, one like this, and there's going to be one over there, and behind that podium is going to be Bill Nelson. Bill Nelson has been in public service and office since I was 3 years old. He's not going to be easy to beat. He looks like central casting for a senator. Right? He's going to talk about being an astronaut. He's not going to be easy to beat. He's going to raise a lot of money. He doesn't have a primary. So who's going to be standing at our podium? Who's going to be holding the flag for the Republican Party? Better be somebody who can stand on the stage with them. Better be somebody who can say, you know, with all due respect, Bill, I was there. And I was there when you voted to cut seniors' health care by $500 billion. I was there when you voted to try the 9/11 terrorists in New York City. I was there when you voted for the stimulus and all of these other things. Or I was there right after you voted for the stimulus. There will be a clear choice for the people of Florida, based on record and based on vision. I can beat Bill Nelson. And I think that makes me different. There will not be a stature gap between me and Bill. There will be if someone else wins this primary. So it's a big decision. Now I want to talk to you about what they're saying about me. Because you need to know the truth. One of my competitors likes to talk about the fact that I used to work for Charlie Crist. And that apparently is his whole campaign. It's George worked for Charlie Crist, and therefore he must be a liberal because Charlie Crist went bad. I worked for Charlie Crist. I was a deputy attorney general, and I was the chief of staff for a year. And then after I left, he went left. Now, I'm not going to say anything bad about him because he's my friend. I'm very disappointed in his political choices. No one is more disappointed than I am. And I'm sure many of you are disappointed, because the truth is that nearly all of you, if not all of you, back in 2006, once he won the primary, and maybe even before, supported him. And so did my competitors, by the way. Because I remember them coming in the office and schmoozing with the governor and all that, so let's be honest. And I was there for a year, and we did some good things in 2007, but you know, I wasn't the principal. You give advice, sometimes it's taken, sometimes it's not. I don't think who I work for is the most important factor in you determining who you should vote for. I think my record, when I was the guy in the chair, when I was the one casting the votes, is the most important thing. And you should know this. Despite my friendship with the governor, when he left the Republican Party, the next day I endorsed Marco Rubio. Not an easy thing for me to do personally, but it was the right thing to do. I've been a teenage Republican president, a college Republican president, a young Republican president, and a party chairman. I was a Republican before I could vote. I've believed in the principles of our party my whole life. And when Charlie Crist left the Republican Party, I was then the highest office holder in the Republican Party in Florida. I was, as your senator. And I stood by our principles, and I put principles above friendship. So if you want somebody who will do hard things, somebody who will do right things, even when they're not personally easy, I think I've proven that I can do that for you. We've got to save this country. I know we can. There's nothing that we as Americans cannot do. We fought Imperial Japan and Nazi Germany at the same time, and we defeated both of them. We put a man on the moon right here from Florida. We're curing cancer. and in our spare bedrooms, in our garages, and now even our dorm rooms, Americans are creating the greatest inventions the world has ever seen, creating the greatest businesses the world has ever known, businesses which employ millions of people and allow those people to pursue their dreams. We are the shining city on the hill that Reagan talked about. We are the last best hope for man that Lincoln spoke about. We are the nation upon which God shed his grace. I know that we can solve these problems. There is nothing wrong with America. There is nothing wrong with our people. The problem is our government. You all are tremendously gracious and nice to have me here tonight. I'm running for the U.S. Senate. I need your help. I'm asking for your vote and your support. This is a big race in a big state. I need you to get involved in our campaign. Anne Marie is here. She's in the back of the room. She's got bumper stickers. They're tacky, which means they stick to your car. I promise they'll come off. Please put one on your car. Please sign up on our website or sign up here. It's georgeforflorida.com. Get involved in the campaign. I need your help to win this election. If we win it, we'll beat Bill Nelson. We'll save America. God bless you. Thank you very much.